Welcome back. The shooting at Columbine High School 18 years ago shook our country to its core. And for the victims and those who love them, it continues to do so. On that April day in 1999, Casey Johnson was in the library when the shots rang out. The 17-year-old was hit in the arm. She survived, but still risked losing her arm. This morning, we are joined by Casey Johnson for more on how a bone donation helped her keep her arm. We just want to say thanks for coming. You have a very busy day ahead, so we're excited to have you here in Cleveland. I want to kind of go back to your story for those who don't know your personal story. We've heard about the Columbine shooting. Tell us kind of what happened on that day for you.
Yeah, for me, it was the one day of the whole school year that I actually stayed at the school for lunch. Mm-hmm. Usually I had driven home to my parents' house where my mom had lunch ready for me. But that day I made my way to the library and was just reading a magazine when just a few minutes later the teacher came running in telling us that there was a boy outside with a gun, and it all happened so fast.
Tell me about the moment right before the shooting.
Right before I was shot, I turned around to see him about 5 feet behind me, pointing the gun at the boy who was hiding behind me. He was not so fortunate to survive, and then it was my turn. And he shot me, started yelling at me, and I really needed him to think he could move on from me. Mm-hmm. So I quit breathing and played dead until he went on his way.
I was reading an article and you were saying something about an angel being there.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. I feel like I felt a hand on my back, and I had turned around actually to look who could possibly be hiding with me, and there was nobody there. But right when I felt the hand, there was just a blanket of peace that came over me, knowing I was going to be shot. And I really think that it saved my life.
With this many years ago, is this something that crosses your mind?
Every day.
Every day.
Yes. Sending my own kids to school is very hard. And every day I drop them off, I just pray I get to pick them up. Yeah. And that sounds heavy, but it's my reality, thinking that I'm putting them in a situation that I was in that was so horrible. At the same time, I don't want to put my fears on them. I want to let them grow up living a normal and joyful childhood.
Have you ever wanted to talk to the parents of the shooters?
I would love to sit down and talk with them, not in an angry way, not just to have a conversation, especially as a parent myself now.
Yeah.
Just learning their journey and how things happened and since then. And I can't imagine being them.
Right.
I wouldn't want to be in their situation at all. And maybe just to offer grace to them and say that I'm okay.
And now you have an amazing platform and you're going and speaking to different groups and different luncheons and those who may have survived similar situations. Tell me about Life Bank, and you're a big advocate of tissue donor. So tell me a little bit about that, because you can thank a doctor for saving your arm, right?
Right.
Because
yes.
of that.
Well, really, the doctor couldn't have saved my arm without the donation.
Right.
So I am a big advocate for tissue donation. The young donor whose bone I was given to save my arm, her family gave a great gift.
Yeah.
And it didn't medically save my life, but it really saved my life. Living as an amputee would look very different. I have 4 little kids.
Yeah.
I need 2 arms
to
hold my babies.
Yeah. And you were an RN.
I was a nurse.
So
yes.
You needed 2 arms for that too. So that
yes.
gave you that opportunity
right.
as well.
Yes.
So you go and you speak to different people, and you kind of say in this article that I read that it's a club that you're in that nobody wants to be in.
Right.
But now that you're in this position, you feel responsible.
Yes. So I feel like when Columbine happened, there wasn't this so-called club.
Yeah.
And it is a club that nobody signs up for. But, and I'm part of another club of being a tissue recipient. So
right.
2 different clubs, but really just wanting to welcome people into the club and walk the journey with them and find the beauty from the ashes, really. And we get to choose to make a great life story out of something so tragic.
Yeah, you're so beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you for coming and sharing your story. Casey is actually going to be speaking at Life Bank's 10th Annual Legacy of Life Luncheon, which is sold out. You can see why. But if you'd like to register to become an organ, eye, and tissue donor, of course, we have a link to Life Bank. It's on our website, fox8.com. All you have to do is just click under Seen on TV. Casey, it's an honor to meet you.
Thank you. What a story you have.
And you're doing amazing things, so don't ever forget that. Congratulations to your beautiful family.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.
You're gorgeous.